In this video, I would like to quickly introduce you to our ALCMS system, or Airfield Lighting Control and Monitoring. This system provides state-of-the-art remote control to air traffic controllers over S4GA lights, as well as it provides maintenance personnel and technical personnel of airport company with individual light monitoring. Key elements of ALCMS are UR201 control and monitoring unit. It's a brain of the system and it's the element that provides communication between the lights and ALCMS. PC, touchscreen monitor, and router that combines and connects all these three elements into the one local network. Now let's briefly talk about each element one by one. UR201 control and monitoring is essential element of the whole setup. It is responsible for establishing connection between ALCMS and the lights on the runway. It sends the commands, it controls the lights, and also it collects the data from the lights. It transmits this data to PC. PC unit stores the data about the lights in the database, it analyzes this data and transfers it further down to a touchscreen monitor that actually presents this data in understandable graphical format for air traffic controllers and for a maintenance team. Now let me present you with our ALCMS system in details. ALCMS is designed in accordance with regulation and requirements of FAA, ICAO and EASA. What does it mean? It means that the system is as reliable as it can be, it is safe, it is secured, and it is compliant with all applicable regulations. Let's talk about functions of ALCMS. We need to divide those functions into three functional groups. Group number one is the control. Group number two is a monitoring, and group number three are critical notifications. Let us speak in more details about ALCMS control function. Control function enables us to control intensity of lights and mode of lights. We have here three different groups. And we can group the lights or equipment into the system within airport preferences. For example, runway, taxiway Alpha, taxiway Bravo, Papi, and so on and so forth. Now, each group has the same parameters that you can select. Of course, number one is intensity selection. How many levels of intensity can we change? 5. So in ALCMS, we can adjust intensity in 5 different levels: 1%, 3%, 10, 30, and 100. So let's see, for example, how can it be done. Let's say I want to activate my runway lighting group on intensity 1%. First, when we select intensity, it is highlighted with orange color. It means that the command is sent, but not yet confirmed. As soon as our intensity level changes from orange to transparent, it means command is delivered to the light itself and confirmed. Now, another very, very valuable feature is the operating time left on the given intensity. As you can see right here, on the right from the plus sign, there is an hours that are automatically calculated when we activate light on given intensity. So, what kind of conclusion can we make of this information? For example, 332 hours, is it long or is it short? Well, for the airport it means safety, because 332 hours means 14 days, 24 hours days, continuous operations without any charging, without any power supply. Airport can operate constantly without interruption. So now let's briefly speak about special modes of operation of lights. We have three: NVG, dusk to dawn and flashing. NVG means that lights will be operated in infrared modes, which means lights will be only visible in noctovision goggles. Dusk to dawn means light will be automatically operating in dusk to dawn mode while using solar panel as a photo sensor. And flashing is just a flashing. How do we activate and deactivate those modes? First of all, if you would like to activate night vision, we simply click here, night vision. System will ask for our approval to transfer between visible and infrared mode. We have to approve. And then system will activate lights. Then we have to select intensity level. We have five intensity levels in this mode. If you would like to deactivate the lights, we press this button right here and we change intensity level to zero. If we would like to activate dusk to dawn mode, again, system will ask for permission. We have to approve. And then system automatically set up lights in 1% intensity level. If you would like to deactivate, we do it like this. And then we have to change intensity level to 0%. So now let's move to the monitoring part of ALCMS. It provides us with information about each individual light, so we can collect data from lights and we can present it to maintenance and technical team. So let's see what kind of data is available to a user for each individual light. You can see there is a group threshold end with lamp number 2. Lamp battery level is 100%. Light is online, which means there is a communication between control unit and the light itself. Light is currently off, temperature is almost 50 degrees Celsius. Light is being charged from the solar panel and charging efficiency is 20%. Why 20%? Well, since battery is 100%, the solar charger decreases its efficiency automatically not to overcharge the battery. You can see also other parameters that are available. There are many of those. And for those who would like to see full details, you can click on more details right here and you can see up to 17 parameters for every individual light. If for some reason you believe that this or other parameters are supposed to be at the very beginning, you can actually adjust the columns with data per your preference. And the system will automatically adjust all the data. Apart from lighting system, ALCMS monitors parameters of UR201 control and monitoring unit. You can see them above the lights. You can monitor data drive, radio transmitter unit, backup battery, power supply, and status of system devices. Basically, we can summarize it as ALCMS monitors power supply, data collection, and radio connection of the UR201 unit. Let me tell you about critical notification panel. Imagine airport, imagine busy day. Many things are happening at the same time. What if your system is about to crash? You need to know in advance and you need to make a decision. We have decided to create a notification panel that stores all critical and safety-related issues to this screen, so your maintenance team, yourself, have immediate access to this data. On top of this, you can decide which of things that we believe are critical to you, and you can also prioritize them. You can go into the ALCMS setup and here you have a thresholds. You can define them as per your preference. And on top of this, you can also define your email server and those critical notifications can be sent to you over email. Let me explain you briefly about thresholds for critical notifications. You have several parameters that you can yourself define. In my opinion, the most important ones here are number of online devices, which means that if you set up here 90%, then when amount of lights will be less than 90%, your system will notify you. As you know, there are certain regulations in ICAO or in EASA that requires you to abort operations when you have a number of yards of your lights are less than X amount. Battery cycles used more than, this is for the maintenance team to know when to exchange the battery, for example. S4GA remote control system allows for remote activation of lights via pilot activation or GSM based activation. What does it mean? It means that pilot arriving to the airport where there is no air traffic control can activate the lights with the help of push to talk button by pressing 3, 5, or 7 times, and anybody with a registered phone number can activate lights change intensity with the help of regular cell phone. Now, in order to deactivate or activate those functions, we have this part available in ALCMS. We go to setup. As you can see right here, you have activate VHF, so it's a pilot activation, and activate GSM. Both types of remote activation are linked to timer. So when we activate anything remotely, then it is activated as long as it is defined in a timer. And timer can be set up from 15 minutes to 120 minutes. So let's activate now timer on 15 minutes. And now let's deactivate those functions. When remote activation is deactivated, means that when pilot is arriving to airport, the system will not recognize his commands. And when anybody with a registered phone number would try to send a signal to system via cell phone, via SMS or by calling, the system again will not recognize those commands.
This makes S4GA the world's safest runway lighting.